What are you doing? What are you doing? Hey.
All right, we're doing a little ice fishing today. As you can see behind me, we got the Wheelhouse out. I'm hooking it up right now. I think the plan is we're gonna bring it out to out of Swift Ditch. And we're gonna try to catch some fish. I don't know how far they're letting them out yet, but I mean, it's kind of crazy to say something like that when it's already February next weekend, but.
I bought this Wheelhouse last winter. I used it a lot last winter actually, but as you can see, it's a nice little shack. I got, you can fish four holes here, there, 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 and then this bunk folds up and then you can fish two more holes here, so. But yeah.
Me and Adam are gonna bring it out there this afternoon and we're gonna try to get on some fish, so. What do you think, Kane?
Good to go.
The one problem I do have with the rig is it doesn't drive down the highway very nice, but. So, we're gonna go air the tires up because it hasn't been driven a long distance in a while, so. But we'll see how it goes.
Rusty bump.
All right, we just picked up some bait and some food. Where it's about 4 o'clock now, so we're not gonna get fishing until about 5-ish here. So we might be able to catch some here this afternoon if we hurry it up here. So, but yeah.
Well, we're working on getting the fish all set up here, as you can see. I'm about to drill some holes. Adam's currently banking the house. It's a little windy out here, so I don't know how this audio is, but nice clip, we'll probably be fishing.
I'm going.
Well, we're fishing.
We are fishing, indeed. Finally got set up. It's about 5:45.
It's not that late, is it?
Yeah, it's 5:45.
Gee.
There ain't much sun left, though.
No. Yeah, she's dark. But anyways, we got her set up, and I don't think we're expecting much tonight, but we'll be fishing tomorrow and Sunday, so between the 2 days, we should be able to catch some fish for you guys, so stay tuned.
All right, well, we're back out. It's the following day now. It's like 7:30, 7:45-ish, and I just put two rattle reels down here as I set up the house, so we'll see how it goes today. Hopefully we can get on some.
Adam and his brother are fishing right there. So
you might see some clips from Adam too, so we'll see how it goes.
It's not a big one, but ain't a bad one. First one of the day for me. Another sauger. Not a big one, but better get him back, so.
The rattle reel just got hit.
There, I got one. I'm on the rattle reel. I don't know if you can see the hole from here. But this is my first fish of the day. And you got all wrapped up in the rattle reel. What do you know? Here is my first fish of the day. It came via the rattle reel. I'm marking another one on the Vexlar now. So let's hope it's starting to pick up here. I just measured it. It's only a 12 and a half inch fish. And
don't want to keep a 12 and a half inch walleye, so we're going to let him go back. So we're going to let him grow, so. So the one fact about rattle reels that I forgot was you kind of have to be strategic when you pull them fish up, because otherwise this happens right here. And then you get to deal with that. It's not fun.
Yeah, I'll probably throw him back.
Alright.
Little itty bitty guy. First walleye of the day though. Little white on the tail. Okay, well, you're going back then.
Holy. I got one.
There you go.
Oh my god.
Catching any?
Oh my god, it's a perch.
Really?
Yeah.
Big one?
Decent.
A keeper?
Yeah. Well.
Oh.
Nice little perch there. Probably, here. He's about 11 inches. It's a good perch. So, we're gonna keep him. It's only my second fish of the day now. Talking to Adam and them on the phone right now. I think they've caught 5 walleyes, so there's one. Well, Adam and Andrew came fished with me for a little bit out here, but it's been real slow today. I've caught a couple small walleyes, nothing worth keeping. You saw one of them. And then Adam and Andrew have caught about 4 walleyes, they said over there, but hasn't been too great, so hopefully it picks up here. Alrighty. Attempt number 3 here today. Sunday now. We got out here too late on Saturday, on Friday night, and then last night or yesterday we didn't have much luck, but yeah, we're gonna try catching fish today and then we're gonna pull the fish else off the lake, so. Stay tuned. Rattle reel's getting hit. There it is. Haven't set the GoPro up yet, but here's one. Oh yeah, a little walleye. Well, would you look at that, Caner? What do you think? I don't know what he is exactly, but 14 inches. Yep, we'll keep him. All right, we got a rattle reel down, and then for my jigging rod, I'm just using a buckshot with the head of a chub, so see how it goes. Oh! Oh my God. I missed him. It's a hungry fish. I got this rattle reel down and I got my jigging rod here. And
I've just been swapping between this rattle reel and this rattle reel. So, yeah. So I've been marking fish pretty much this whole time. You can see one marked at the bottom there. Just that yellow off the red here. And then my hook is up here. But just hard getting them to bite. So I've changed baits about, I don't know, tried three or four different tactics, different hooks, but nothing's getting them to bite. Rattle reel's dancing around, as you can see. Yep, here we go. Got him. Ooh, nicer one. Lost him. Dang, that was a nice fish. Felt pretty heavy. It's a shame.
All right, I'm not completely packing up yet, but I'm gonna show you a little bit of my process on how I do that.
So as you can see, I started to unbank the house. I didn't do the best job showing you on how I set it up, but I just shoveled out the snow because then it's easier to crank and pull out when I do end up doing that. But one thing I always like to do is point my door, especially if I'm leaving it here over like a long period of time. I like to point my door, either keep my door pointed either east or south, because the wind usually blows from the northwest, so especially up here in Minnesota this time of year. So, but yeah, there's not too many houses on the lake yet. I mean, I don't blame them. There's only about 15, 16 inches of ice. Fishing's been slow. It has been all weekend, but that's just how it goes. So sometimes you catch them, sometimes you don't, but just the way it works out here. So let's see if we can catch some more fish before I fully pack up here. And then if not, I mean, that's just how it works. Okay, so I keep some important things in here. I don't know why I have paper bags, but I have a mystery tackle box that has never been opened. I think it's a walleye and crappie box. Crowbar, just in case the house freezes to the ice. Lighter, obviously. Trash bags, you don't want to leave garbage on the ice. A bucket to give the dog water. Some more hooks, so you can put your tag on the house. Pliers, nail clippers for line, some weights for the rattle reels, fishing line, portable charger, flashlight, a hammer, yeah, just some stuff like that. But you never know when you're going to use it.
All right, well, I'm going to call it there. I ended up catching a couple perch and a couple walleyes this weekend. Fishing was slow. The fish weren't cooperating very well, but you saw those fish, and you may or may not have seen Adam's 4 or 5, whatever they caught over there. So, but anyways, it was still fun to just bring the fish house out for the weekend and get on the ice. So make sure to like and subscribe. But thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.